Sad, but my job is so important. I need to help the amendments to be the best they can be so that it can best help the people and so the bills can be right. Man, I'll have to decline the invitation.
When do they start? Come on, secretary, where's my agenda? I'm just gonna check my social media first. Let me see. What is there today? Ooh, there's a basketball game. I don't know my schedule, but I wanna really go to this one. Today is fine. I can go. Secretary?
My fellow congressman, I have little time to address you, so please be attentive as I speak. One of the issues that I want to talk to you about today is homeland security. Keep in mind, this is something very important. Unlike trade or agriculture, this is all about people's lives at stake. So we need to take this very seriously. Issues such as army reduction or army reinforcements or even gun control need to be established. So, I don't know, are there any suggestions?
Our subcommittee could work on amendments for gun control in order to make it better, and there's various issues that we could make amendments for a bill.
Yes, very well. What was your name again?
Steve Chadwick.
Okay, good to know. So, are you the director of the subcommittee?
Yes, I'm the chairperson.
Perfect. So, you're in charge of gun control, and I hope that you do the best as...
That meeting was boring, and now I have to go to Junkin. But first, I gotta eat something.
Man, that was a very productive meeting. Now it's just time to go lobby.
Miss Oneto?
Yeah, that's me.
Hello, I'm Mike Conaway from the House of Representatives.
Good evening.
And I'm here to ask you the opinion of the farmers in this district about the new bill that we proposed. It was SNAP, right? SNAP, right? SNAP, right? Did you hear
that? What does that even mean?
I think it's the abbreviation of supplementary nutrition. Wait a second, I'm gonna...
What a persuasive congressman we've got here.
Okay, Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program. Did you even hear about it?
No, don't even let me get started on that. That food stamp nonsense you want to impose on us, that means there's going to be an over $8 million cut on farming subsidies. That means over 850 households will lose $90 per month of the benefits. My family has been in the farming industry for generations, and now, out of nowhere, because you want to give more power to the labor, you leave us farmers apart? No, you've got to take a different stance on that, sir.
Okay. I was kind of expecting this reaction from you, so that's why I'm here. I'll make a compromise, okay? Mm-hmm. So,
I'm hearing.
How about, since I don't have much time, so let's make it easy and short. How about, since re-election is coming next year, I wanted to propose that if you persuade your district to vote for me as the new senator, as the representative again, then I'll be happy to be against the new bill. How about it?
That might work. I do have a voice in this district, but now that we're getting into business over here, you know, my brother just lost his job. Is there a way you can maybe get him new labor opportunities? I bet I can make a little extra effort on my part to get more voters for you.
That seems...
Yeah.
I have a lot of friends that work in big businesses. I can look a job for you, for your brother. So.
Sounds good.
Okay, deal?
Deal. I hope and wait for your re-election, sir.
Thank you. Good to work with you, Mrs. Bonetto. See you later.
Whenever. My pleasure.
Hi, Mr. Chavez. Someone from the American Medical Association is here, and she would like to speak to you. Should I just send her in?
Yeah, just send her in. I'd like to speak with her as well.
Good morning, Mr. Chabot. My name is Dr. Rogers.
Nice to meet you, Dr. Rogers. I presume you're coming here to talk about the 21st Century Cures Act. Is that right?
Yes, it's right. Since I'm one of the head board members of one of the largest and most important associations here in America, I just wanted to come to give the pros and cons my association specifically has about this issue. The thing is that this act will provide quicker and cheaper ways for patients to save their lives, basically, because the pharmacists will have the right to put on the market medicine without as many trials as they're now supposed to have. But on the other hand, that gives way to inferior quality medicines as well, and that can hinder a lot of patients and even kill many. So that's what our point of view is, and I just wanted to know how things are going in Congress. If there's a big possibility for this bill to pass, or is there another way?
I believe over half of the House representatives are in favor of this bill passing, and around 77 are against it. But I'd like to have another meeting with you in order to discuss more on the topic and to form a better opinion on it, whether I should vote for it in order for it to pass or not. When do you think we could get together?
I believe that would be a good plan. I'd like to have a meeting next week. Is that okay? We can arrange it for them.
I'll look at my schedule and see if I have any time free. How about the 22nd?
Yes.
It's a couple of days before the actual voting, before it gets passed either to the Senate or it gets debunked. And hopefully we can get a good outcome of our meeting in order to have a good opinion on this subject.
Okay, that sounds great. I'll be waiting.
Next meeting, gotta get organized, gotta go get breakfast. I better go. Don't have enough time.